When K-pop idol Kwanghee was discharged from the Korean military in December of 2018, fans and reporters were shocked at the very noticeable weight loss, earning him the title Paper Human for how thin he became. Since then, Kwanghee appeared on variety shows to talk about the 9-kilogram weight loss. Kwanghee said that he was worried because Infinity Challenge, the show that he was on at the time, has ended, and there was uncertainty and lots of media attention about his future career in Korean entertainment. He wanted to improve during his time in service, so he resorted to improving his visuals. He said he wanted to return to the world looking handsome and good on camera. Kwanghee said that he cycled and ran on the treadmill like crazy for about 2.5 hours each day. Kwanghee went from 59 kilograms to 50 kilograms, which puts him in the underweight category. He mocked himself, saying his slim face reminded him of the famous painting, The Scream. He even said that he was obsessed and not sane. Fortunately, Kwanghee has put on some weight since then, but his case clearly shows that strict beauty standards of K-pop put an enormous pressure on individuals. It also shows that beauty standards also affect men, not just women. And hopefully, it's clear that extreme dieting is bad for your health. So, who started this? Is it the consumers who demand these high beauty standards? Kwanghee did say that he wanted to be loved by his fans. Or is it the K-pop industry that produces and reinforces it? Kwanghee also said that he wanted to shoot more advertisements, and brands tend to like thinner celebrities. The answer is both. It's like the chicken and the egg problem. It's hard to say which one came before the other, but they influence and shape each other. Who knows? If consumers start demanding bulkier body shapes or darker skin tones, the industry might change. What do you think when you see Kwanghee's paper human body? What does K-pop beauty standards demand from male idols? How might these standards change with the globalization of K-pop? Let me know in the comments below. My name is K-pop Sociology, promoting the critical consumption of K-pop.